Hey guys, as always, thanks for stopping by. Well, just when you think you've seen it all before, have I got a doozy for all y'all. This one's gonna be fun. This video is brought to you by TechMat. I love these things. I've got them on all my benches and I take them to the range every time I go. They're on Amazon, link right down below. So a few nights ago, there was a town hall meeting up in Virginia and this guy, Delegate Mark Levin, he spoke. That's a constitution he's posing with there, sarcastic LOL. Little background, Levin is a constitutional lawyer, graduate of Harvard and Yale Law School. Levin is out of the 45th District of Virginia. Now, you've heard of the Beltway in D.C. That's the 495 that encircles all of Washington, and it's kind of the mark of the hub of D.C. politics. And Levin's entire district is literally inside the Beltway. This is not some Virginia farm boy. He is an activist politician, Ivy League educated D.C. lawyer. So at the town hall, Delegate Levin was asked about the assault weapons ban that's in committee right now in Virginia. And instead of simply saying, hey guys, I literally know nothing about firearms, but I do want to share some statistics and research with you, no. Instead, he stood up and like a typical Washington elitist, he decided to give a lecture to the audience about firearms. Let me show you some excerpts from Levin's response. This video is from a YouTuber named John LaRue. I'll put a link down below to the entire video. Take a deep breath, y'all. Here we go.
So if the goal in my legislation was to distinguish hunting weapons, weapons used for self-defense, weapons used for sport shooting, from weapons that are the preferred weapons for mass shooters. And so what the bill does is it distinguishes basically the difference between guns that go like this. These are rifles. You use them to shoot an animal. And you can shoot very precisely with a rifle, an animal. These are the guns that hunters use. They go like this. And you look down the barrel, and you can shoot very precisely. You can have a scope. Those are the kinds of things that hunters like to use. Mass shooters don't like things that go like this. Because what that means is someone can hit the rifle butt against their head. Deer don't do this. Elk don't do this. So the mass shooters use guns that go like this. All right? Pistol grips, things like that. And guns that go like this are wildly inaccurate. That's why hunters don't like them. But mass shooters do like them. Because their goal is generally not to accurately shoot one person, like an assassin, but to shoot many, many people fast. You may know that in Dayton, the shooter got off some 75 rounds in less than 30 seconds, shooting 40-odd people, while the police were right there. That's what these guns do. That's why they're so useful in the military. You want to mow down an approaching army. They're not useful for hunting. They're also not useful for self-defense. The best weapons for self-defense in your home are a shotgun. What's a shotgun? A shotgun's very powerful. You shoot a shotgun, and it shoots some 40 pellets out, and if someone's coming to approach you and they face the end of a shotgun, they're in big trouble, right? So for self-defense, people also use pistols. They use concealed handguns. What the bill does is it looks at semi-automatic weapons. Sir, feel free to write something on a card and tell me why you think I'm wrong. What the heart of what this bill does, and there are many things this bill does, but it does is it bans extended magazines. So one of the things we found is that if you want to shoot a lot of people fast, you need to be able to shoot without changing the magazine, the thing that holds all the bullets, right? So if you have 30 bullets in your magazine, you can shoot 30 people just as fast as I can move my finger, and kill them all before you have to change and get a new magazine. In terms of the differences between the guns, the heart of the difference is how you hold the gun. And it must contain one of these weapons of war type features, things like a pistol grip, things like a flash suppressor too, which basically conceals where the flash is coming from. So our bill allows people to keep their weapons, including their AR-15s and the like. They can keep their weapons, but we've asked them to do what people have done with machine guns when they were banned in 1934, to basically get a permit so we know where they are so they aren't used by criminals.
Now, one of the things that we all do, and people on both sides of the aisle do this, we dismiss people with one word. And I had the same reaction after watching this guy. Woo boy, what a moron. And I bet a lot of y'all had the same thought. You dismiss the guy with a single word. And that can be a really powerful tactic. We literally cannot have a discussion about our southern border without someone on the left playing the racist card. And with one word, hey, you're a racist, the entire conversation comes to a halt. But we do the same thing on this side of the aisle. I hear people all the time 100% dismiss people. Oh, that Bernie Sanders, he's just an idiot. He don't know nothing. Joe Biden is just a kid sniffer. Nancy Pelosi, yeah, she's just a pill-popping hag. And Hillary, well, she's just a drunken old battle axe. Yeah, we've all done it. Now, don't hear me wrong. I'm not defending these people. That's not my point. I'm saying that all people, me and you, are too complex to just dismiss with a single word and a wave of the hand. I watched this video with Delegate Levine, and my first thought was, what a total clown. That's maybe partially true. It's literally a parody of someone talking about firearms. But as I thought more about it and I did my homework on this guy, I think it's actually a worse situation than I originally thought. On one hand, it would be concerning to have an idiot in office who knows nothing about guns making legislation that affects all law-abiding citizens in his state. And I'm going to call this one concerning. But on the other hand, what we actually have is an organized, tenacious, well-educated, experienced, and a power-hungry leftist who also knows nothing about guns and is making legislation that affects all law-abiding citizens in his state. And this side, this one's concerning, this one is terrifying. And I think it's why we need to stay vigilant in this day and age right here in 2020 and be more involved than ever before. It is critical then. Past years, it's always been critical, but now more than ever before. That's how I see it. What do you think? Leave me a comment down below and dismiss me with a single word. Thanks for watching, y'all. I'm Johnny. Let freedom ring. Bye.